I first got interested in archaeology through the influence of my aunt, who is an archaeologist herself. And when I was 15, she said, "Hey, do you want to come on a dig in Sicily?" And who would not say yes to that proposal? So I went on a dig in Sicily and realized that this was the best way to actually touch the past. I'd always been interested in history. I'd always been interested in what had gone on in the past. And this was a sort of a direct connection. And that's what has pushed me since the time that I was 15 to continue in this field. It's really about human stories.
In the past, archaeology was often driven by the desire to collect pretty objects. A site was excavated, the attractive and valuable artifacts were removed, and the rest were discarded with little or no mind paid to the valuable data, the history lost among the ruins. Chersonesus was a Greek colony on the Crimean Peninsula that thrived during the Byzantine Age. Adam Rabinowitz has been involved with the dig there for the past 10 years. But the history of the site goes back much further.
Chersonesus has about a 185-year history of excavation, and you can look at the records generated in the field by an archaeologist who was working in 1890. So you'd have photographic negatives, you would have the recording sheets or the notebooks that you use to take notes and write down context in the field. And all of these things have a physical existence, and as long as you don't let them be burned or soaked in water or eaten by bugs, they will survive for a relatively indefinite period of time.
But digital technologies have changed archaeological fieldwork. New advancements mean more data is being collected, it's being collected digitally, and it all has to go somewhere that is safe and accessible for both the long and short terms. Rabinowitz and his team were collecting a lot of data from their dig in Chersonesus, and in 2008, much of this information sat on a single portable server that they carried back and forth to the Ukraine.
Is any of this going to be available in another 100 years? Because if it's gone, then there is no way to reconstruct it.
Excavation is inherently destructive. After years of displacing dirt and extracting pottery shards and bones, archaeologists are often left with nothing but documentation, artifacts, and a big pit. The site itself can never be physically reconstructed, but with the right information, the right data and data structures, it can be recreated virtually so future archaeologists can re-examine the raw data, ask new questions, and draw new conclusions. This is when Rabinowitz and his team turned to the Texas Advanced Computing Center.
You know, working with an archaeologist is a great match because the archaeologists have, like the archivists, a sense of time, a sense of future, a sense of, you know, why do we need to preserve these things, and also a sense of context, how these things need to be preserved so that they can be interpreted and reused in the future. And he was seeing the limitations.
Working with Esteva, a digital archivist, and David Walling, a database expert, Rabinowitz developed a state-of-the-art data management system for his project. To illustrate the power of this system, Rabinowitz shows an interactive map of a Byzantine residential block at Chersonesus that was excavated by his team between 2001 and 2006. The block was pillaged and burned in the middle of the 13th century and was left as a well-preserved snapshot of life at that moment. A padlock found there dating to the late 12th or early 13th century AD serves as an example of why context is key.
A lot of these locks, there are a number of them in museums and private collections, almost none of them with context, because they were beautiful objects. And so people bought them on the market, people dug them up and sold them as objects. So here we have a very rare opportunity to look at this in a contextual setting.
In addition to the standard pictures taken of the lock after it was pulled from the ground, all of the data from the dig site itself is accessible through this map. Icons show where and how the lock was found, smashed into two pieces, probably by the axe of a looter, as well as information about other items found nearby, including an iron bucket and the skeleton of a woman in her 50s left lying in the street under the rubble of a collapsed roof.
The other interesting thing here is a door lock. An iron door lock lying in the street. The door lock probably to this door right here. So somebody kicked in the door, grabbed the stuff, ran out in the street, dumped the bucket, probably wasn't worth anything, knocked the lock off the strong box, took the gold, and booked, leaving the, the building in flames. So this is a much more vivid depiction of this particular moment than you would get with a traditional archaeological recording system. We were very fortunate in our collaboration with TACC, essentially in Maria, because Maria served as a bridge between our discipline and our way of speaking and thinking about things and the supercomputing disciplines. So we brought a new set of interesting issues to TACC, and they brought a set of skills and an infrastructure that would allow us to feel a lot more comfortable about the long-term safety of our data.
For centuries, people have created things on physical format, and some of those things have survived. So now we have to take care of the digital objects. And scientific data collections, this idea that they can be reused and you can integrate information from the past, information from yesterday, to find solutions, to answer questions, to make discoveries, is a very challenging and a very interesting possibility. So this is what I like about this job.